morning. Thanks for tuning in. The local share market's going to get off to a reasonable start this morning. The futures are telling us that the ASX 200 will be up by a little over a quarter of a percent when we get underway later on this morning. So not a bad outcome. You have seen a lack of conviction really one way or the other where buyers and sellers have been concerned in recent days, with some good reason, because the anticipation of the data coming out in the back end of the week was just stymieing risk-taking initiatives in that regard. So we're on the eve of some important figures, if you like. So at the end of the US session, we had the Dow Jones down by a third of a percent, the S&P 500 up by around 0.2 of a percent, and the NASDAQ up by around 0.4 of a percent. Again, not startling by any measure. The moves, we're orbiting record levels in a variety of markets, including our own. We're only less than a percent away from recent record highs. And over the course of the next couple of days, some big data points out that will make a difference, or potentially in terms of calculations around things like activity and interest rates. So that's precisely what happened on Wall Street. Not making things any easier was that we tended to see the interest rate markets bump up a little bit. So you had a two-year note at 4.7%, a 10-year at around 4.31%. Bottom line is you have seen interest rates bump up against their recent highs, three-month highs, which makes the next couple of days important. We've got the US Fed's preferred measure of inflation as the marquee outcome in coming days. We're coming on the heels of hotter CPI and hotter PPI figures. If that narrative continues into these figures, then you could see these bond yields continue to push higher. And that would be interesting to see how stocks weather that. Balancing things is that the economic piece and the earnings piece has been holding up quite nicely. So we're heading into an interesting window of time, if nothing else. So there were really some modest highlights last night as far as reflecting on what happened in US trade. One thing that stood out was durable goods orders. So these are important numbers because they are a measure of business investment as much as anything else. So they can capture goods that are anywhere between a toaster and an aircraft carrier in terms of what has been delivered. And this measure had its sharpest contraction since April of 2020. You know, when you unpack the figures, they weren't quite as bad as or negative as the headline suggests, but still worth watching as well. Didn't really have much of an impact on the markets, having said that. Elsewhere, we had quite a bit of corporate news out. We're making our way into the back end of the company reporting season in the US. Constellation Energy is an organization that's focused on clean energy production. They delivered better than expected earnings numbers, and the stock was up by more than 13%. Norwegian Cruise Line. So according to this organization, demand for hopping on a cruise ship and having a break is at record levels, and that went over well in addition to the fact that they delivered better numbers. So that stock up in the order of about 15%. You had Macy's shares a little bit firmer as well, up by around 3%. They're going to close down a number of their stores, about 150 actually, and that went over well with the markets, in addition to the fact that they had a bit of a downbeat note to their earnings report. And Viking Pharmaceuticals, they had some good news in relation to a weight loss drug. That's the new black as far as pharma companies are concerned. So some reasonable moves as far as corporate outcomes were concerned. European markets a little bit firmer generally relative to their US peers. The Stock 600 index up 0.2, German DAX up 0.75%, the French market up by about a quarter, the UK market just in negative territory. In terms of relevance for our own market, we had a little bit of a recovery for the mining stocks in Europe, which is a contrast to their recent experience. So Rio shares up by about 2%, Anglo American and Glencorp up in the order of around 1.5%. So that might translate well to our own experience today. The only caveat to that is that you've seen iron ore prices continue to moderate. They're currently trading around their lowest levels in about 4 months. I've spoken before about some of the factors that are working against iron ore, including rising inventories, contracting margins at steel mills, etc. So overnight you had iron ore down by about 0.25%, not much move there really in the biggest scheme of things. As far as the local experience is concerned today, the Reserve Bank of New Zealand will be handing down an interest rate decision. So that's important because they've actually been talking quite tough on rates, and it's a question of whether or not they follow through on that today where the decision is concerned. It's still a marginal possibility, but one nonetheless. We've got the monthly CPI figures to look at in local terms. So they don't carry as much water, if you like, compared to the quarterly figures because of the nuanced measures that are included from month to month. But nonetheless, with inflation in the title, it always warrants attention. So the figure to look out for is the annualized pace of inflation to the month of January will come in at around 3.6% according to expectations. So if you get something north of there, that could prove troublesome. In addition to that, we have got a reasonable list of organizations reporting their earnings: Flight Center, NextDC and Worley. The mining services organization is set to report figures as well. The Aussie dollar, look, it hasn't really been doing much since it had that failed attempt at around 66 US cents. So it's been moderating since, trading around 60.5 US cents. If you get something interesting and pop up in those inflation numbers today, that could make a difference. So have a great day, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow morning.